Return of the Mac Podcast, MAC.
In the building.
Moss, Andrew, Carl.
Yep.
In the building. The Word Residence holding it down.
Yeah. As you can see with all of the Steelers shit.
Not either one of our spots.
You wish.
I do not. Episode 167. Yeah, 167, baby.
Yeah, what's up, fellas?
Getting up there, man.
What's going on? Much going on?
Nah, man. Same old stuff.
Wait, was it last week I missed?
Yeah.
I missed last week, right?
Yeah.
Yes. No. We was at your crib last week.
No idea. Everything is confusing to me.
You haven't been in my crib and recorded yet.
Oh yeah. Okay. Maybe that's what I'm just getting fucked up.
But you're not going to next week.
Yeah. You're still not gonna be there.
Yeah. So when you said earlier in the week that you weren't gonna be available for Halloween, I didn't pay no attention to like the dates or anything. I assumed that was this week. So I saw Moss. We were playing poker Saturday.
Yeah.
And I was trying to figure out the pod situation. And he's like, oh no, he's good. He's good this week. It's next week.
So yeah, Halloween. Yeah.
Next week, Halloween, it'll just be me and Moss again. But we got the whole crew.
Hey, y'all dressing up, though?
No, never.
For the pod?
Never.
Oh, damn. I was already Tatum this week.
Shit. Nah, bro. You got to get a costume. Y'all got to get costumes and shit.
I don't.
Get costumes.
Yeah, bro.
Why do I need to?
It's Halloween.
Oh, no. I don't do Halloween. Halloween is
whack. What you going to be this year?
I'm a dad.
So you're not dressing up yourself while you're over here.
It'd be good for the pod. You could be like a mummy or something. Moss could be like a vampire or some shit.
Why were those the two choices?
I don't know.
Generic ass Halloween costumes.
Could be a ghost.
You could be a ghost. Just grab a sheet.
Just cheap.
I won't be a ghost. I won't be a ghost on the pod.
No.
No sheet wearing for me. Moss can wear a sheet if he wants to, but I can't get away with that. Be very problematic.
I'm
for
just
the
thinking pod. Of some.
Didn't think
some
about
ideas.
That one.
See,
didn't think about that one.
I wouldn't advise. Don't
she
don't wear
with eyes cut out.
I never thought about that being like. Why would you put your child in, as a
white? Can't be a white.
They didn't. They didn't think about that shit. They didn't think that through.
Definitely didn't think that through. But as soon as you say that makes me think of Django.
Yeah,
the scene where he's talking about cutting out
movie,
cutting out the eyes though.
Yeah.
His wife did it.
Oh yeah.
I think we can all agree this was a great idea.
That shit was hilarious.
I can't see shit out this thing.
Oh, Django's my God. Y'all don't appreciate that. Was that that one? Y'all don't appreciate nothing.
Yeah, something
my
like
wife
that.
Spent all day making these masks.
One of the funniest scenes ever. As soon as you said something about the eyes out, I was like, yo, cutting out the eyes. My wife spent all day cutting these eyes out.
Yeah, it's a good movie.
Super random.
Classic.
Yep. Yeah, for sure.
Not sure how we got here, but we
are
here.
Oh, y'all could. That's what y'all could. That's a costume.
He could be Leonardo DiCaprio.
Mr. Candy.
Miss Candy, and you could be Django.
That seems
that'd be a hell of a costume, though, if you dress like Django, because it's like
it'd be wild, right?
Yeah,
Django.
I mean, those outfits he was wearing was crazy.
Yeah, it's gonna be hard to portray Django. With what you're wearing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I mean, you could dress as a slave, but I don't know if anybody would want to do that for Halloween.
We should probably.
It's been done. Believe it or not.
That video you shared, I saw this week, those guys are hilarious. I don't know what their names are, but those like two guys that go around doing pranks and shit, and they dressed up as slaves for a Civil War reenactment.
Yeah.
That shit was hilarious, man. Yeah.
We thought we were late.
And they had a bag of cotton they threw on the ground and started picking it up and singing like slave songs.
They're
and shit.
So good at staying like serious about
it. Yeah, I don't know how people do those videos.
I don't either. But they were, I don't know those two guys, but that's like that style of prank video or whatever, like that's what those Nelk dudes.
Yeah,
that's what they
much,
came up.
Doing. Yeah, they're pretty much the same. They're just like super kind of flagrant, or not really flagrant, but more.
Nah, flagrant.
I don't. But it's another. It's probably a better word to describe it though that I can't put my finger on right now. But I don't know. Is you gotta have some balls to do the shit that they do and keep a straight face type thing.
Like, I don't know how you could. I don't know how you can keep a straight
face.
Like
you could body that shit. You like the straight face guy.
I could do it. I'm good at it, but I don't know. When you're getting the reactions that they're getting, Right. I don't. Right. I'm too pussy to do it. So I could keep the straight face, but I couldn't, like, I once people started going crazy, I would just be like, all right, yeah, yeah, it's a joke, it's a joke.
Yeah, I would give up too fast on it.
Yeah.
Like,
I'd be doing that shit like at work and shit all the time. Serious with people and then they just see how they react.
No clue what to say.
That shit is hilarious every time.
So
I be getting a kick out of that shit.
I mean,
everybody takes me dead ass serious.
But it's different with people you know, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, the people you're familiar with.
But no, I be doing it with, like, the students and shit. Like, they all don't be like that. I'm dead ass sometimes.
Well, you're in, like, a comfort. These dudes be going out of their comfort zone and shit. Like, this
they
is
come
in completely.
Can I get some of that? Nah, can't get none of this. They be looking at me crazy. Oh. I'm like, yo, I'm just.
All right.
Yeah, they just look at me like they don't even know what to say then. It's like, he said, nah, all right.
all good.
Nah. You can't get none of this.
I saw one of those videos last week that they had done, the Nelk Boys had done. It apparently is a brand new one, and they put a pumpkin with Kanye's face carved on it, and then a pumpkin with White Lives Matter, and put it on people's doorstep. And then he rung the doorbell, and he was like, hey, you know, I really don't appreciate this the message that you have on your pumpkin. And the lady comes out, and she's like, what is it? And she reads it, figures it out, immediately calls her husband, and he's like, I'm going to go get the FBI neighbor, and my husband, he's a police captain or whatever. And the guy's like, you know, I don't want to get the police involved. I'm out of here.
Because she's like, I know you did it. She's like, I don't even know who this is.
Yeah, that's
she's like, it's Kanye. I don't even know who Kanye is.
No, stay here because I think you're a part of this.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, the dudes who can do those videos, you got a different level of courage, honestly.
You do.
Because you just never know how somebody's going to react to that shit.
Nah.
I thought, yo, what if this person got a gun?
Yeah, people are too crazy nowadays.
Right, yeah. I don't know. I guess you got to choose your target wisely.
Never know.
Yeah, for sure.
Anything for the content.
Yeah, pretty much. Right. To run the views up. Risk your life to run the views up. That's
pretty much
what's about.
Is where we are.
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Anything going on this week worth mentioning?
Shit going down.
Not really. I mean, my dogs are barking and shit right now. That's what we hear upstairs. They're loud as fuck. I'm about to tell them shut the fuck up in a second.
Must have heard something outside. But just same old shit, brother. Another work week.
Same
you know
here.
What I'm saying?
Yeah. Pretty same much old. Same shit. Nothing to speak of, I don't think.
Yeah, nothing for me neither. So we can just go ahead and get right into it. We've got basketball got started this week. Obviously, you know, we've got football stuff to get into. New music, Jeezy. So. Plenty of topics to get into.
Yes, indeed.
NBA, we just touch on this real quick. Obviously, only a couple of games into the season. I think 3 games in or something.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't really care about basketball getting back leading up until this. Like when we're doing all the preseason and stuff. But I forgot about how nice it is just to have games on all the time.
Right.
It's a luxury.
I don't really tune in to like watch full games of NBA
too,
like that.
I like some bullshit.
Yeah, great matchups and stuff. They're trying to get, you know, grab the people into the TV crowd, but it's just really nice to have. NBA is just NBA is one of the best sports to just tune in for a half an hour. Yeah, like you can just turn on the game, watch for a little bit, like that was some fun basketball, go back to whatever you're doing or whatever. Mm-hmm. Football, I'm kind of sucked in the rest of the way.
Oh, you got to watch a full football game.
Right.
You know, you have to. I mean, because you just don't understand.
It depends on the football game.
Right, but I'm just saying, you don't.
Yeah, Thursday nights.
Yeah, I mean, just like a good game, especially if you want to like recap it or recall it or anything like that. Like, it's so many instances, like little moments in a football game that swing momentum or it's just like.
I mean, basketball is like that, too, if you like to watch basketball.
In a way, but it's such fast pace that it's different. I don't know.
I think the thing with basketball that makes it different is the runs, like how quickly you can come back.
Yeah.
Right.
In football, you give up 2 touchdowns in a row, you get down 14. It's like, all right, this game's probably a wrap. Basketball game, team goes down 17 points in the second quarter, and it's like, all right, well, how are they going to come back? And knowing the fourth quarter is going to be a 5-point game.
You get a totally different feel how the game was by just looking at the stats. Like you do, than actually watching the game. Because like you said, somebody could have been up 20 points and came back and then swung back another 15.
You can watch some basketball highlights and pretty much watch the whole damn game. You watch some football highlights, you're going to miss a whole lot of small details that really have impacted and affected the game.
It's the same thing.
I don't think so.
In fact, you'll probably miss more in a basketball game than in a football game.
I mean, I get what you mean by that.
Yeah, but just like I said, because it's more plays, it's more.
Yeah, I get what you mean, but those, they're so like, they're less impactful though, because there's so many of them. That's what I'm saying. Like, right. They're gonna show you the all the impactful stuff that happened in, but it's like a penalty in a football game could kill a drive so much, and all you see in a football game is them kicking a field goal, and you're thinking, oh, they drove down the field, but they could have actually had, you know, chances that field goal ended up being like a 4-point swing or some shit like that, or, you know, or however you would say that.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm saying. Like, it's little details like that in the football game where you have to watch it all to understand, or the, like, to get the full context of certain stuff that happens.
Sure.
In a basketball game, you can get all those major moments out the highlights, I feel. Or, I mean, you can look at the stats and be like, well, Ja Morant went off for 49 points. They whooped some ass. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's, oh, yeah. It's, I mean, pretty
blowout
easy.
Is a blowout, and it is
right.
But like, you know, tight games, it depends. Depends on what happens.
Yeah, I guess right in a tight game, but I don't know. football is different though, for sure.
Any standouts or anything from any of the early NBA season?
Man, y'all see what I got on right now? That big zero, that big boy Tatum, going for that MVP season.
Yeah, is that what you think so?
He on a killer. Yeah, I already called it. He getting the MVP this year. Or at least in the top three of the range.
Like, what's the betting odds?
I don't know. I never even checked.
I'm not sure what they are.
I should have bet it.
I would assume maybe Giannis and Curry are
probably changed up after these first three games.
Yeah, I mean, I'm still talking about coming into the season.
Yeah, yeah. Giannis, Curry, Jokic, and Embiid are probably like the top four MVP odds. Tatum's probably in that second tier of. They wouldn't be crazy odds. You get good odds regardless because you're picking an MVP at the beginning of the season. But like, I would imagine you probably find Tatum for like plus 600 or some shit.
Yeah, I can see that.
I think that would be within reason.
Has
he been balling out? I honestly haven't paid a lot of attention to him.
102 points the first three games.
Oh shit!
Yeah,
35, 29, and 40.
Yeah, but yeah, okay.
So he has done the damn thing.
And not to mention, I know they probably ain't gonna talk about it as much. JB been getting busy too.
Game one, right?
And then they both had like almost 30, like 28 and 29 in the last game. I think the last game, JB only had like maybe like a 12 or 15 or something like that. But them boys going at it. It's the best duo in the league.
But I mean, Jason Tatum's not going to average 35 points.
Wait, you should listen to what he's saying
now. I'm saying.
You said that the best team in the league?
No, best duo in the league and one of the best top two team in the league. Right now, number one.
Wait. Before you respond, wait, you were going to say, okay, I thought you were going to have a fit because of the Warriors. But no, as soon as I said it, I was like, nah, at this point, I think duo-wise.
Yeah,
they're the best duo.
Nah, you're right about that.
You got to give it up.
It would have to be them, I think. I'm trying to run through the teams.
You can't put Clay in that equation no more.
No, it's supposed to be KD and Kyrie. So pump your brakes on that.
You think they're the best duo in the league right now?
They don't play well together, of course, right now, but individually
it can't be the answer.
I will call the best duo.
I'm just saying, like, if we're three games in. Most talented two players would be that.
We're about three seasons in. I mean, I know Kyrie didn't play much last season, but.
Being realistic, that's all I'm saying, is they're supposed to be the top duo.
We're not talking about supposed to. We're talking about what it is.
Right. I mean, look, we're talking about what it is. I'm fine with your take there.
But that was your way to disagree.
Yeah, he was trying to like find a disagreement.
Why am I supposed to sit here?
No, we ain't doing that.
It's just like if
Lil Wayne would have had more bars, he would have been better. No. We gotta talk about what it is, not what
bro,
it could
stop
be.
It.
What we
stop
doing?
It. Stop
what
it, bro.
It is. What, that's it.
No. I'm just saying. That's it. Somebody has to. Like, it's so many great players in the league. So, I mean, you got to look through it.
It's a lot of great players. I'm just saying, it could switch up.
The Pelicans have a pretty good duo coming up here.
The Clippers could have an argument at the end of the year if they stay healthy.
Damn, that's a big one.
All right, but I'm glad we got here because that is actually one of the things I had written down. Yeah. Did you have anything else on the Celtics? I wasn't trying to crush Celtics combo.
Okay.
The Clippers.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we did this on the pod, not like at great length, but we had like a fairly passionate discussion about the Clippers once they signed John Wall. And me and you were pretty heavily not interested in the Clippers, right?
Is that I'm not a fan of John Wall.
Oh, yeah. Right. Y'all forgot. John's still that boy.
Yeah. All right. So what I wanted to say is I feel really strongly about taking risks on injury prone players.
Right.
So I have heavy reserves against the Clippers because of all three of their big guys having injury problems in the past.
Yeah.
But after watching some of their games over these first couple three,
they deep, yo.
If they're healthy, dog, that roster is deep, fucking loaded. Loaded.
They got a bench starting five that could probably, like, at least three of them could start somewhere else.
Yeah. I know this was just injury related. This won't stay the whole way, but Kawhi was coming off the bench game one.
He was.
I mean.
Which is wild to think. Think of, you already started, and I think they started Reggie Jackson and
Morris.
And PG.
They got so many people. Game one, they had six and they players come off the, in double digits.
And you come
digits.
Off the bench with John Wall and Kawhi?
Yeah. I mean.
Like, what?
Again, I mean, it's all going to be injury-based.
Nobody was a high scorer. The first game, the highest score was 15 points, but they had, again.
I think PG had like 40 the last game.
They had five players over at 14 points or more. And the next Kawhi Leonard had 11. So
yeah,
I mean, at that point, if everybody's scoring, you don't need nobody to drop 30.
Kawhi and Kennard, and it's like, bro, what?
I'm a huge fan of Kennard, man. Always, you know me.
Really?
He's always been big on Kennard.
I didn't know that.
He's when we talked about this great player.
Remember when I was like, oh, we were talking about Jason Tatum? Like, when I was watching him at Duke, I'm like, yo, Jason Tatum's a great player, but. Fucking pass the ball to Kennard sometimes. Yeah, damn, yeah, wide open in the corner.
I was like, no.
That's nuts.
That dude's a striker.
Tatum's a top three pick for a reason.
Yeah.
Passing the ball to Kennard.
Kennard was a top pick, too, though.
I am a fan of his game. Like, I think he's a
He almost like Klay Thompson.
I think he's
like, but not as good. I'm saying, like, game style.
He can hoop.
I don't know. I won't disagree or agree. He's a very, very, very good role player.
Right. Yeah,
that's what I think. Like,
he's probably one of the best bench players in the league.
Yeah.
Facts.
Yeah. Well, you've got a guy like that as your sixth man or seventh or eighth, ninth man, whatever they're considering
him. He just don't get no love.
Look,
right now.
Well, he got paid. He got love from the Clippers.
Yeah.
I would have kept him too if I was them.
They let, who was it go? It was Harrell. It was Montrezl Harrell. They let walk and they paid Kennard, and Harrell was furious.
For real?
That was when he went to the Lakers after.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah. Gotcha. Gotcha. Yeah. Gotta keep that guy.
Boys look good, man.
Yeah, I don't remember what we were even
talking about. John Wall.
John Wall. Yeah, the Clippers. Yeah, if they stay healthy, look, they're going to be a problem. And I just wanted to walk that back a little bit.
Terrence, man.
Yeah, but Paul George gave him 40 in game two.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, he said Kawhi didn't play that game.
Yeah, I think. He sat that game.
How many games is Kawhi going to play, though?
They'll manage him heavily all year.
With them being so deep, they don't need him to play as consistently.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
And I think that's exactly what they was planning on. Well, but getting all
do you
players.
Think that ruins things for them when it comes around playoff time?
No, because when the playoffs is when you most need them the most.
Right. I mean, he's gonna play them, but what I'm saying is like team chemistry and shit like that.
I think
he's gonna be playing during the season.
Last season, they was like, they actually played well. They was in. They made the playoffs.
Yeah, they did.
They made the playoffs without PG and Kawhi playing most of the season.
Yeah,
PG came back in the end and just fit right in the end like he had been playing the whole season and was hooping. So it was like they've shown that they'll be all right with whoever's out there.
And then he's been there for a little bit now.
Yeah, that's true.
Like even though he was out with the injury, he at least had one season where he played with them at least part of the season.
Yeah,
I think it's a little bit different than like the chemistry issues have come up for these teams that are
like the Nets.
The first time they're bringing everybody together and then having not everybody get to play together throughout the season. Mm-hmm. I think since they're on like their third year, I don't think it'll be a problem, but I mean, certainly could come.
I'd like to see Kawhi win another championship. I can get on board for that.
I can see them making the Western Conference.
I don't hate it. I have no feelings towards Kawhi.
Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, he's when healthy and when playing, he's one of my favorite players in the league for sure. Mm-hmm. For sure. I love his game.
He's super talented. Like I enjoy watching him, but I just it doesn't excite me.
Really? I mean, when you watch him play, he has a boring game,
but it's just
it's so efficient.
It's incredible to see how he just overpowers whoever he's playing.
Well, it's
defensively and offensively.
Yeah, I mean, it's not even overpowering though. It's just skill.
It should be overpowering though.
I mean, he got skill though, man.
It's like you can't. He's so strong. You can't knock him off his mark. Whatever he wants to do, he's going to do it.
Yeah, right.
Whether he goes through you or whatever, however he has to do it. Kawhi is solid. To any move he makes, he's making that move and he's going
to
get that
foul. Yeah, it's all about getting to a spot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If Kawhi get to a spot.
That's what's crazy about him.
It doesn't matter who you are at that point. Yeah. You're a cone. Yeah. Right. I got you're to this spot.
You know what you about to do type shit.
Right. Yeah. That's what it is. You're like, he's just getting to a spot. And that's what I like about his game so much. That's I always said. It's like Kobe to me.
Yeah. He really was built to stay a Spurs player for real.
What's that?
He really was built to stay a Spurs
player. Oh, he was.
He should have stayed.
That was their type.
Just because his game is just like fundamentals. I'm going to do the right thing, get boys, play defense.
Supreme San Antonio.
Yeah.
Super like even kill type person. Like, don't get too up, don't get too down.
Do your job type shit.
Like, you've never
seen. Barely tell he's alive.
Yeah, I've never seen him like hit a big shot and like go off or something after.
Nah, son, if he didn't go nuts after the
imagine him doing like the Steph Curry shimmy or some shit. Mm. It would, like, yo, what the fuck?
Yeah, it would look so weird.
Yeah, he probably would look weird shimmying.
Yeah, like, yo, what the fuck is going on?
I don't like it
because of his shoulders.
Has there been any like random players or rookies that you've noticed that stood out to you at all?
Rookies or random players?
We're literally three games in. I have two guys in mind. If you don't, you don't. It's not a big deal.
Who you got? Maybe a job.
This is one kid I'd never heard of in my entire life until 2 days ago. A rookie for the Pacers. Hmm. His name is Benedict Mathurin or something like that. He was their first round pick.
Mathurin?
Mathurin. He went to Arizona last year. In three games, they haven't played the stiffest of competitions, but in three games, he's got 19, 26, and 27, and he's coming off the bench.
Damn. That's kind of nuts.
Playing for the Pacers. So I've been gambling
they
wise.
They've been playing a good amount of minutes, though.
Playing starters minutes, right. But he's coming off the bench. But him and Halliburton are nasty. And if you like to gamble, you're playing a little same game parlays. Yeah. Those two guys are good ones to look at.
I fuck with Halliburton. Oh, Banchero.
Yeah.
That motherfucker looks solid.
I was going to mention him, too.
The Magic not going to be good, but he looks solid.
Yeah.
He looks solid.
I think that's
solid.
All he worried about, though.
He looks solid. Like he stepped on that court and was like, I'm going to get 8 to 9 boards, give about 15 to 20 points. I'm going to just do this.
No, he's averaging 23 points and about 9 rebounds per game right now. A little over 3 assists.
Yeah, they said game one, I don't know exactly what his stats were, but he was the third person behind LeBron and Grant Hill to have a 25-5 first game.
Right. Yeah. And I mean,
yeah, I think I looked at that game.
Shot pretty efficient.
Like the Pistons or somebody or something like that.
I believe it was, yeah.
He's shooting at 41%. You might want to see that jump up a little bit, but that's good.
Yeah, three games in, who knows? Right. He could have one bad game and it goes what it is, but he does look really good early on.
I think we all knew he was going to be pretty good.
Absolutely.
He's built for it. Until Orlando get their shit together, he probably just going to ride down there, though.
I don't think he
could. Because they're not going to be that good.
Yeah, I don't think he. He doesn't strike me. I mean, everybody wants to win, but he doesn't strike me as the guy that's like built a team. Like, I'm a carry the team type of guy.
I think they could build around. They got a couple pieces.
I mean, yeah, build around him, I'm sorry, but like carry the team. Like, I'm a carry us to a championship kind of guy. He doesn't strike me as that kind of dude.
Man, I don't know.
It's like if everything works around him, but I think he's just concerned about being the best.
He's already shown that he could lose one.
Like, personal, haha. Funny guy.
is there anything particular that makes you feel this way? I haven't seen anything from him that would leave you one way or the other.
I don't know why I see Melo when I see him. For some reason.
Just because he has a good mid-range game. I'm telling you that's all it is.
I don't know why. And I think that personality-wise, they might be kind of similar in that way. Like, I'm not saying that Melo didn't want to win, but it's like Melo wanted to get to the money. You know what I'm saying? Like,
we know the Melo thing.
Melo wanted to be the best possible player he could be to get the bag.
A Ben Simmons that would shoot.
Ben Carroll?
Yeah. I don't know.
I think it's because he's light skinned.
Yeah, I don't know about that. Ben Simmons
because he dribbles the ball well.
And he passes super well.
He does pass, but
of course he's getting boards. He's not plays a point defense. Guard. He's not a point guard.
He ran Duke like a point guard.
But yeah, kinda. Like they let him take the ball up the court type shit. I was watching some
of the game. I think he has that ability.
Yeah.
A lot of players can shoot.
He can actually pull up and shoot. So I don't know.
I don't know. I think it's a little unfair to attribute that to him yet.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, right. I have no idea. This motherfucker but going to win 5 championships.
The Melo more like interested in self goal than champion
that's what
kind
I mean,
of way.
There you go.
I knew what you're getting at.
Oh, damn, that's what you were going with? Where you get that from?
I haven't gotten that vibe yet.
I don't know, but it could be true. That's just how I feel.
I have no idea.
That's just how I feel.
Well, he ain't got his ears wet yet.
We'll see.
The only other two guys I wanted to mention is Ja. It just continues to be leveling up in the first three games from what I've seen.
Jazz.
And I just found out today that Dame has 41 in all three of the first three games.
Yeah, that's crazy. Dame back.
So, he's on a mission.
Dame is fucking back.
On the somebody bench. 41? Had a wild take I saw that three said that fucking Dame was, he would put Dame over Kobe all time. I'm like, you tripping.
Oh, but Dame's a great
that's like one of your takes.
No, nah, bro, I would never say something so crazy, but I'm like, oh, you gotta be a Blazers fan or something.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's just
But I mean, Ja is he's that dude's nuts, man. He is
the best shot his draft by far. By far.
I'm not gonna
called it.
I don't concede to that. I think.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say something cool there.
What do you mean?
I thought you were gonna admit that, like, if you're going up to this point, he has been.
We've said that. I've said that already.
Right. I'd like to hear it from you again.
He's been an available player. He's carried his team to the playoffs. He's been one of the best players in the league. One of the top three, four point guards in the league, probably the last two years or so.
At least the last two.
So
at least last season, maybe not the year before, but at least last season.
Yeah, right. I think after this year, the conversations are going to be about if he's in the top five or not in the current league.
It should be.
I think after this year, that will be the conversation surrounding him. I think he gets plenty of notoriety. I don't think he's under the radar by any means. Everybody loves Ja, so they like to give him props and stuff. But I think by the end of the year, he'll be like, "Yo, is Ja top five?" And it's a legitimate conversation at that point.
Yeah, we'll I think it should because they'll do it for Luka, and their teams are kind of constructed the same, built around guards. They're superstar guards, and
who's better?
Morant been doing his thing.
Who would you say was better?
Better. I think they're better for different reasons.
Who would you rather have?
Who would you rather have, Luka or Ja?
I think that's an interesting question.
That is a good question. I take Ja.
I think I would too.
I take Ja.
It'd be hard not to take Ja though.
What Luka does is
like Luka is incredible. He does everything. He's one of those guys that you would want to have that, but I don't see him being like the driving force for the team type shit. I feel like he still needs something. I feel like Ja can win with this team he got right now.
That's a good take.
I really think he can win with this team like that. Ja, they've been trying to find another piece to.
I mean, it's not AI, but he got like that AI kind of gravity.
Gravity.
You know what I'm saying?
You feel that with Luka? Luka has that same type of presence in games.
Yeah, maybe.
I agree. Actually, I thought that's who you were talking about. You said Ja has the AI.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
No, he does. He does. I think
it's just that level
on the ground like AI. I know that.
What'd you say?
He does that every time he goes up for a layup. He's hitting the ground after this type of shit.
Yeah,
that's wear and tear.
I wanted to talk about that shit. Why the fuck? I don't understand how basketball players hit the floor so much. It's just never been.
I mean, because the thought process is it's better to just go ahead and fall to the ground than to try to stop yourself from falling because that's how you bend something or tear something. By trying to stop yourself.
I get it. And I mean, I get they play probably more basketball than they would know probably better than me.
They're also selling a lot of calls. Yeah, or at least trying to.
But I just couldn't imagine. Like, you know what I mean? You play basketball a lot. Like, how many times have you ended up on the fucking ground like
that? I used to be that guy.
Yeah. Really? On the fucking
ground? It's really the safest way to do it.
Iverson was my guy. So, like, the way I played basketball was I was driving into the lane and I was jumping into people every single time.
Really?
So I was the guy that was finishing every layup on the ground. I got fouled a lot, but I was like borderline out of control going into the lane for sure.
Oh shit!
Yeah.
I used to fuck my ankles up sprain my ankles all the time, not by getting crossed, but most of my ankle injuries was coming down off a rebound or coming down on the ground
on somebody
and standing on somebody's foot. So sometimes it just be better to just go ahead and go into the ground and trying to stop yourself or land. Because you can land on somebody's foot and roll your shit easily.
Those are nasty ones.
Easily.
Sound like you need to.
Yeah, the coming down on the ankles those are always nasty.
The worst, man. The worst.
Yeah. I don't think you go wrong with your question either way. I think Luka is a better player, but I would rather have Ja. I think Luka falls into that trap that we've talked about with Westbrook and Harden, where they have to have the ball in their hands too much. And that was like a massive criticism that Luka was getting in the past playoffs. That's not my take. Mm-hmm. I was listening to other people saying that he just dribbles the ball so much that it doesn't involve the offense sometimes.
Well, that's all. I mean, it's really.
So I prefer the Ja style point guard.
Way of playing basketball now, right? Like,
to just dribble, you mean?
Yeah. You know, it's now today is that more fluid, get the ball up court. You know what I'm saying? We're not doing a lot of half court sets throughout the game. So, yeah, I mean,
yeah, adjust to the competition.
Right, the
competition
right.
Is moving. They on the move.
Ja going to get up the floor.
Yeah.
So I think that's probably why I would take him.
Yeah.
Just for that reason alone. So, yeah.
Can't argue with that. Plus, he's been an underdog. He's been an underdog his whole life. So
pretty much. Yeah.
I like that where Luka was the guy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, his story is dope. Like, yeah. He wasn't, like, necessarily. Like, he had a crazy growth spurt, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I guess he was kind of the low man on the totem pole. He wasn't, like, highly recruited or anything like that. It's dope when you see shit like that and then just watch this dude take it to another level. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like,
well, because even once he got to school.
Was crazy.
Yeah,
he really just like took it over and came like as one of them cream in the crop just gonna rise with the opportunity that came. And he went crazy.
He used the platform. He used the platform of the NCAA tournament. He put motherfuckers on notice.
He was going.
He got drafted and paid for it too. So shout out to him.
To go from not even thought of to a top three pick.
Yeah.
All because of the March Madness. Like before that, he was not talked about in that manner at all.
No, him and Zion played on the same like AAU team or some shit.
Yeah, the scouts would come to see Zion.
Right.
They weren't paying no attention to Ja
at all. They didn't even know who he was.
Yeah, that's wild.
Somebody gotta talk to those scouts. Huh. You could come in and see everything that you needed to see with Zion and say, hey, there's also this other dude that we should be taking a look at.
Years ago.
Yeah.
Crazy how shit can turn.
Yeah. Man, anyway, what about the Lakers, man?
Yes, that was the last thing I was going to mention.
What's up with your boys, Moss?
My boys. Did you see what I got on?
Yeah,
you
always, tough,
this is the most defending to call
tough
my
to boys.
You always defending Westbrook and shit, so that's why.
I'll defend Westbrook this time. I got you.
Yeah, because I don't like the bullying.
I got you.
And now at least... At the very least, they're still getting their shit off on Russ, but it's not just Russ.
Oh, they all suck. Yeah, they all stink.
You know, it was crazy
to
me.
Except for LeBron.
They like, what is it, like 18 for 100 or something?
From three?
From three.
Yeah. Oh, the shooting percentage
Why
for the guards
Why y'all still
is
shooting the ball?
Because that's how basketball is
played. Inside out, dog. Like, y'all ain't got it. They obviously don't got it.
They big man don't really want to do that as much.
That's a legitimate criticism. I think it should go even higher up where they built the team.
Yeah.
You know that this is how basketball is played now.
Yeah, you can't
not be able to shoot the three.
Yeah.
They had off-season needs and decided that we should go get Patrick Beverley, who I am all of a sudden becoming a fan of because check out Pat Bev's par. He's a funny dude.
Of course he has.
I do like this guy. I got to be honest with you.
Draymond.
But yeah, they picked up guys like him. It's like that was never going to work.
It doesn't make any sense.
And at this point, they are just
doesn't make any sense.
I definitely got it.
Let's go get another bad shooter.
But they're fully now scapegoating Westbrook, and I think it's bullshit.
Yeah.
He looks awful.
He does.
Don't get me wrong. I'm not caping for the way he's playing, but they're blaming everything on Westbrook as if he's the problem when the whole team construction is the problem. And at this point, I've legitimately gotten to where I feel bad for Westbrook again.
Yeah, you got to get out of there.
He is who he is, and I can understand teams either wanting to be a part of that or not. But he so clearly doesn't want to be there anymore. Yeah. He's tired of being the blame for everything.
And people won't give credit for him being professional about it.
Now he does deserve.
Every time they ask him questions, he's being real professional. Like, hey, it is what it is. Da da da. I'm just here to do my job and do my thing. He know he ain't wanted there. He heard the rumors.
Yeah.
You know they was trying to trade him before the season started.
Now he does deserve.
They not want him
props.
There, so he's just playing because he's under contract. I'm gonna come to work and do my job. Hey, if I'm asked today, it's whatever. Y'all don't want me here anyway.
He's not like, playing with much confidence.
So it's just like,
right now.
Either move on or I'm going to just keep coming to work every day and just doing what I do. But yeah, they're terrible.
Well, he had the 0 for 11 game one.
0 for 11.
Yeah, game two wasn't much better. It was something like some small amount for 14. It's not going to work. And I think they're just fucked.
You see the clip going around now where he took a shot last game with like 30 seconds left. Oh, yeah.
Dang time game.
It was like 30 seconds left, and they were up by one, and He came down the floor and immediately took a jump shot.
Yeah, early like, in the shot clock.
And LeBron and AD are in the background like, yo, what the fuck is going on? Like, it's definitely going viral right now.
Yeah. I also seen that joint with, I think they had started the game off like 0 for 11 from 3. And LeBron just shot that 40-footer and that shit didn't even touch the net.
Oh, he just, see that.
He pulled that shit on some like, jeez, fuck it. Like on some shit like, damn, y'all fucking suck.
Wild.
Yeah, they're going to be a terrible unit, but again.
That's LeBron just playing. Man, I do
come
fuck
on,
with LeBron.
Come on, come on, bro.
We're going to do this the entire season.
What happened? Come on, bro.
He just wants to reiterate his point from seven years ago.
It's not from 7 years ago.
We need to hear this again.
No,
wrong.
It took COVID to save them.
Now, we're not to
buy them. COVID got them a championship. It was a reduced season.
You can say that. They still
so
got one.
So AD could actually stay healthy, and they were in a fucking bubble. And we know that's the weakest championship you've ever seen won in your
life.
I
don't agree with that. But
100% agreed on everything that you said. It still doesn't matter. They got the championship. You make the trade to win a championship. All is well.
How long do you think this drop lasts for? What? With what we're currently looking at, this bad, this Lakers like being terrible. Because LeBron's not
2 to 3 years.
That's it. LeBron's not going to be there in 2 to 3 years.
Yeah, or I think that'll be when they can come back again.
Yeah.
They've gotten themselves in problem because of their contract stuff. So until they can get rid of Westbrook, until they can get rid of AD and LeBron, I don't think they'll probably win another championship.
You think they're going to have to bring people in then? Like, because they're not going to be drafting somebody and developing them because they haven't done that yet or in a long time.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't care. Hopefully they suck. I mean, hopefully they suck.
I think they've signed up for 10 years, a decade of terrible basketball. I think that's what they did. They signed up for a decade of terrible basketball.
I mean, it had already been a decade before they got LeBron.
I mean, was it a decade though?
That's solid.
No, it's not that long. Yeah. It hadn't been that long.
LeBron just got bad.
It's probably like 5-6 years. It won't a decade.
And 5-6 years is a century.
In 2010, they won a title, didn't they? In 2010,
I don't know.
Or maybe
that's still about 9 years.
Maybe not. I don't know. Yeah, yeah, right. It's close. 9 years. It's on the line.
Yeah.
I agree with that. But I mean, I don't know what superstar they're gonna bring in.
They're gonna get another guy.
Yeah. Does somebody want to be in LA?
It's the Lakers, yeah, bro. On. Like,
it's the Lakers. They might want to be there. You know,
Lakers in the NBA. Ever since Buss took over that team, that's what they do. They can go get their guys to come.
NBA is the easiest league to be able to get one or two guys and get back to good again.
Yep. They in LA.
We'll see.
Everybody wants to be in LA.
We'll have 3 months to have this conversation over and over and over again. Let's talk about
now. You know why.
As
I told you earlier, now you know why.
Yeah, let's talk about football. Jesus Christ. Let's just ignore it. Just
you don't know what I'm talking about? Okay.
Look, this is my week. Shut up, Carl. This is my week. NFL.
Hold on,
the Panthers are back.
Hold on, bro. Can you plug me up real quick?
I guess.
Kill real quick, bro. I'm sorry. Before you even start, I don't mean to cut off your steam right now. I just need to play one thing for you, bro. Dedicate this to you right here, bro.
All right, dedicated song. I respect that.
Yeah, I got a song for you, bro. Just a dedication song for you right quick. You feel me?
I feel better that Moss is coming up with this. If it was from you, it would be bad.
The good times I made it last.
I feel you, bro.
I used to be able to hit that high note,
man,
like that.
I had to play that. I played that song when we lost our state championship my senior year, leaving from the game.
Why you want to cry like that? Why you want to cry like that?
Bro, I just like, yo, bro, I was hurt, bro. That was my senior year.
You want to add to that emotion.
I wanted to go back to back. I was like, man, it's last game. You know, the season was over. We was in the semi-states.
I know you was boo-hooing.
Motherfucker James didn't block that kick, bro. But, hey, you know. Sorry, Mino. C-Mac gone. I had to put that for you. I don't understand. You got it. That was your guy.
That's all right. He I appreciate go, it. You know what I'm I appreciate saying? It.
He had to go.
I'm okay, though.
Right.
C-Mac was holding us back. The Panthers are a better team without Christian McCaffrey, all right? It's clear that he was the problem. We're going to the Super Bowl now, and all we can do is thank the San Francisco 49ers.
Okay. That was a massive trade.
All right. I'm just kidding. I love C-Mac. I was honestly excited with the trade, though.
I tried to act tough when Brady left, too. Like, it's all right. We're going to be all right.
No. I'm legitimately happy. The trade with the writing's been on the wall. We knew that this move was going to happen. They got back a bigger trade value than I expected to be able to get in return. We got a second, third, and fourth round pick for next year, and then a fifth for the following year.
Got a haul.
So they got a great return on it. Mm-hmm. I love Christian McCaffrey, and I think what he's had to endure as a Panther is not fair to him up until this point, even in the years that he got to dominate and stuff. Going to San Francisco and playing under Shanahan, I think he's going to be a monster. So I have no problems with the trade.
I didn't know about the storyline.
I didn't know about that until right after it happened either.
About what is it? And was it one of their coaches played with his dad, or his dad played with his dad?
His dad played for his dad. Yeah. So Kyle Shanahan is the current coach of the 49ers. His dad, what's his dad's name?
Just something, went blank Mike, on it too. Mike Shanahan.
Mike Shanahan coached Christian McCaffrey's dad.
Right. Ed McCaffrey.
Right, yeah. He was a wide receiver.
Yeah, they were like, he babysat Christian McCaffrey or something.
Right, they all.
Storyline writes itself.
Yeah, he grew up there. Yeah. He grew up in that area. Yeah,
that's why he went to Stanford and stuff. Right. So it was perfect. I'm happy for him. I'm happy for us. Even more exciting for us, or my excitement for us, is that they said, we'll see if this holds true, this could be leveraging, but they said they're not going to trade DJ Moore. They had an offer for two first rounders for Burns and turned it down. They said he's a cornerstone they plan to still build around. Mm-hmm. So it was nice to see in the article I was reading this morning that we made the move that we expected to and got a better return than expected, and we're not going to make a move on the guys that I was hoping we would keep.
Smart.
So I'm pretty excited. Smart
move. I think they said the Rams were in the mix, and I don't know how they have anything left to give.
Rams and the Eagles. Wow. All the top teams were in the mix.
The Eagles?
The Bills were obviously mentioned at the beginning. Any of those top teams.
The Eagles, like, they need another running back? They already play like three or four consistently.
Yeah, I'm just saying, though. He would fit in.
He'd have been great.
I mean, sure,
he'll fit in anywhere.
His talent,
when he plays, he's always been like, he's a one of one. First of all, like, he's always been like one of my favorite players to watch, ever, like, back in the Stanford days. I really have like a Lamar Jackson like love for Christian McCaffrey. He just hasn't been healthy here recently, but people just forgot how dynamic that dude is. And when I saw him play for San Francisco this week, he still looked like he got the pop and the burst and the speed.
Boy,
and stuff.
He looked good when he was out there. He hadn't lost none of it on the field.
Yeah,
Been on the field. There's not been, like, even a little drop-off, like, he's playing injured this week. Like, nah, when he's on the field, he's been the guy, which is why 90% of our offense has run through him.
Yeah, he's everything. Like, when I see Christian McCaffrey, I think, like, he's everything that Reggie Bush should have been in the NFL type thing. Like,
kind of what the expectation was.
Right. He is that guy. And I just hope he stays healthy and shows people that again, because I think – people really discount him or don't factor him into like one of the best running backs in the league anymore. When they you know mention that shit, they come up with the Jonathan Taylors and Derrick Henry's first, and I get that for sure. Those guys are deserving,
you could be injured for a long time.
Saquon
was top three his rookie season.
Right,
but he played
when available, man, it doesn't get much better than Christian McCaffrey, I think.
For sure,
and then you're putting him on a team that has another. One of one,
yeah.
Where what they like can Debo. Do with Debo and McCaffrey,
talking about Debo.
I don't know how
to Garoppolo. Like,
yeah, well, no,
he'll one of one too. I mean, it's a bad.
But
you don't want this one.
But yeah, him and Debo, that's crazy.
Matchup wise, like
They could run the Wildcat.
Imagine going
they
into.
Probably should.
They could run the fucking Wildcat.
Oh, God. It'd be dirty. Probably
should. Be Garoppolo sucks.
The option with Debo is McCaffrey.
Yeah. I'm telling you, when.
Kittle. Kittle's a great player. I mean, they really just. Sarah Fred is really just that quarterback away. Like, they might want to make a trade
for clearly, that's the spot they need to upgrade. I don't even think it's, like, necessary. I really think as the rest of the season goes on, what McCaffrey allows you to cover up with your quarterback is ridiculous.
Yeah, I guess y'all did that.
We tried. We couldn't cover up the stink of our quarterback enough, but he just is such a option at all times, and he's running option routes on guys that can't cover it. Garoppolo can throw a four-yard out. I know he can do that. I don't think he'll be able to hold them back, and I think once you get into, like, playoff formats and shit, and you're, like, really getting into, we've got to win this matchup this one week. I don't know. It's going to be tough for defenses to stop what Shanahan draws up, I think.
Yeah, it's a perfect match with that because we've seen what they can do with any running back.
Anybody.
So you put this guy in there, you know, that juice, come on. I'm excited for him. The Panthers kicked ass without him this week, though.
Yes. Great transition. It was fun week this week.
They did.
As you all know from previous podcasts that we've done, there's nobody in the division that I hate more than the Bucks. I hate the fucking Bucks. It is certainly Brady-related. It is their come-up recently-related. These are fucking bums, and we all know that they're bums. I'll say it again. They were graced with a blessing from the football gods of getting to rent out Brady for a year. For one good year.
Yeah, really, right.
But, yes, we dominated, son. Defense didn't let them do shit. Shut down Fournette. Brady didn't look good. Thank God Mike Evans dropped that early touchdown. They should have had him up early. But after that, you know, our offense wasn't stellar or anything, but P.J. Walker was putting the ball where it needed to go, and D.J. Moore looked elite out there as the only guy that you expect to get anything from. It was exciting just to look good again for a week. I don't really have my hopes up that high. I still think we're going to suck the majority of the rest of the year. But right now, we're one game behind the Falcons and the Bucks at 3-4 atop the division. And we have beat the Saints and Bucks already. We play the Falcons this week. We beat the Falcons this week. We're 1-0 on all three of the division guys, and we're tied atop the division.
That'll be wild.
That shit is nuts.
That would be wild.
Our division is probably going to end up sending
an 8-9 division leader. Right now.
Yeah, this year is really bad.
I know what's going on with the Bucks, but it's like, damn, that shit really
evaporated so fast.
I feel bad for Todd Bowles because it's like, damn, you inherited this piece of shit for real. Like, you thought you were getting a great football team.
Super Bowl champion.
But why are they so bad? They have all the guys. And as much as we want to say, I think you're going to say Brady is not Brady. Don't get me wrong.
He's not terrible now. He's not turning the ball
over. You look
over
at his numbers, like, he's not a quarterback in the league that shouldn't be putting up three points.
It's Brady, but it's not for that reason. I think he could still, like, physically play the game. Mentally, I don't think
I think
he's fucked up, and I think it's fucking up the team, like, camaraderie and shit. Like, I think that has an element to do with it. The motherfuckers might not like the kind of Brady.
They're making a big deal when Brady be yelling on the sidelines. It was kind of like, oh, he's just laying out his line.
I don't think
when he was playing ass.
That's what I think it is. It's not about him laying him out. It's the fact that he wasn't good.
Yeah, he wasn't
good. Like, the game that he played against us, he was missing throws. And, like, now you're talking shit to these. Like, they gave you time to make that throw. You were shitty.
And that craft thing is a legitimate issue, I think.
Yeah, right.
Going to that party after they sucked. I just heard Nick Mangold talking this morning.
Yeah, like, he missed, like, a Thursday practice or something.
It was a Saturday practice.
Yeah.
Saturday practice.
Nick Mangold is the tackle for the Jets from back in the day.
He's apparently
a retired personality now or whatever. He gave his opinion on it, and he was like, look, nobody likes to be yelled at, but I can take people yelling at me if we fucked up. It is what it is, but you miss practice for the walkthrough, for the party the night before, like, I don't want you yelling at me when you couldn't be at practice.
That's how people go feel.
He said, like, I understand Brady's above the team. We all get that. And I think the team understands that too. But there is just something, just like on a personal level. You're not going to miss our pre-pod meeting and then get irritated at us for anything.
Right. Like, it's just not cool. Pissed off. Like, oh, you guys are fucking up.
Just like on a personal level. Like,
he literally told me.
You weren't here. Don't tell me I did something wrong, even if you're right.
Right.
You weren't here where you were supposed to be.
Yeah, I think see that is kind of playing to, you know, after the first year they went and won that championship, and they was like, hey, it was all Brady, not Bill.
Yeah.
I think now we're starting to see the unraveling of what Bill had placed in for the Patriots for so long to why everybody outside, Brady's the greatest ever. He probably runs the team and do his thing. But when you was with the Patriots, you were just Tom Brady, our quarterback. And that's how he was treated there. So that was like a humbling to where you are no different than anybody else on this team. I don't think they run that shit like that with the Bucks.
Oh,
I think they let
not.
Brady do whatever the fuck he wants to do and be Brady. And now you see that dynamic with the teammates where it's like, all right, dog, like, we know you Tom Brady and all, but you playing like ass. You getting on our back every game. It just changes how the team is going to react to you when you do shit like that.
Bro, it's.
And I think that's what we're seeing. Why you need that Belichick and that Patriots system with the Brady for so long, and why both of them meshing together made it what it was. Because, you know, May Brady didn't take certain contracts. He didn't be an asshole. He didn't let his nuts hang like he was and showing off after every game posted shit.
At this point, like, it's really the end of an era, right? Like, as far as Brady, Rodgers, Russell Wilson.
The era's done.
It's looking like that.
Yeah, right. Brady and Rodgers. They're in the same boat, in my opinion.
Matt Ryan. All of these guys are.
Matt Ryan, he been off that a couple of years to me, but whatever.
Well, I'm just
did you hear that news today?
No, whatever.
Ryan got benched.
For the rest of the season.
Sam Ellinger, rookie.
Oh, yeah, that's terrible.
Yeah, they have that's seen terrible. Enough. Yeah, they have seen enough, but
this motherfucker got like 7 picks and 11 fumbles.
I know Wentz, it's like 9
picks or something like that.
I know
Wentz
been bad, but when they traded Wentz to bring Matty Ice, I was like, that's who y'all got to replace him? Y'all thought he was going to do better than Wentz.
They traded for him, right?
Yeah.
Didn't they give him like 2 third-round picks or some shit? Like, it wasn't. Yes. It wasn't necessarily cheap.
I was like, that's insane. And look, he's not going to be the one.
Falcons is just chilling there with Mariota doing way better.
Getting busy a little bit.
Well, yeah, and I mean, they have a better plan because they're like, we're going to get a better draft pick than you probably anyways and get the guy we actually need.
So. Well, there's been a lot of talk about that, though, like with what the Falcons have been able to do with Mariota and then the same thing with the Seahawks.
That's fucking
like the Seahawks
crazy.
Give up Westbrook. They give up Russ. And Geno's the man this year.
Geno,
I don't
baller.
Think anybody thinks that he's like
they're winning their division right now.
Yeah,
right.
And they look good doing it.
Yeah,
like they don't look lucky right now. No, they're scoring balling on people.
Yeah, they're scoring points.
And that boy Kenneth Walker is a monster.
Kenneth Walker
is
nasty. Yeah.
I just saw a graphic today that said over the last 2 weeks he's the leading rusher in the league. But, like, I think he was the third leading rusher if you only took his yards after contact.
Oh, wow. Damn.
I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah,
without seeing the visual. But
after him getting hit, he's still the third leading rusher.
He was at 256 rushing yards total, and it was 200 after getting hit.
Yeah, most of his yards is after
that's
contact.
That's insanity.
He's just running through people. That's the way he was marketed coming out of the draft, like I said, Jonathan Taylor.
Is he the Michigan State kid?
I think he's Oregon or some shit. Okay. I don't know. Hold on. He wore green. I would say that.
So I could still be right.
Yeah, maybe. I'll look it up real quick, though. Let me see. Walker.
Michigan State.
Oh, it was Michigan State. There you go.
Yeah, he was a Heisman candidate early in the year.
Mm-hmm.
And Michigan State sucked. And I don't remember if he finished the year or not, but obviously fell out of the Heisman stuff. But yeah, that kid's a monster.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just wild right now across the NFL, man. A lot of unexpected shit happened. But
still a long season to go.
One thing you can expect is for the Pittsburgh Steelers to be ass every Sunday.
Hey. That boy Pickett was trying to build a picket fence out there, joint one with the picks he was throwing last night.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to ask about. What are your feelings about Pickett right now?
He's a rookie.
I mean, I'm not. I think, you know, he's just you look at the stats on the season, it looks bad. I think he got, what, 7 picks in 3 starts or 3 games. The Jets game, it was, a lot of tip picks there. But I don't know. I like Kenny. I think he can move the ball pretty well. I think he's a fairly accurate thrower for the most part. I think he got a lot of guts. But sometimes, I mean, he's got to show he can close a game, and he hasn't shown that he can close a game yet.
I heard an interesting stat during that game. I thought that shit was wild. It was like the Steelers have had the most, either the most shots or the most open deep
balls. We're taking the most deep balls.
But they haven't completed any of them.
I did hear that.
Or some shit like that. I was like, what?
We've taken the most deep shots in the league.
Taking the most deep shots but haven't completed none or some shit like that.
But I don't think it's not the quarterback's fault.
I mean, you could put most of that on Trubisky.
Played most. But it's not all the quarterback's fault. It's, man, the Steelers run like 10 plays. Their offensive coordinator is awful. Like, it's really simplistic offense.
It looked really bad last night. I don't know if it was just that I paid more attention that game or what, but the offensive play calling specifically, this is terrible.
Yeah, it's been like that though for, like, literally the only way the Steelers moved the ball last year is when Ben went no huddle and pretty much made up his own plays.
Gotcha.
And then we started scoring points. I don't know. I feel like they have to fire the offensive coordinator. I know people are saying you don't want to do that.
You don't need him.
He's awful. He's never been a NFL coordinator before. He was a college coordinator before he got to the Steelers, and he never stayed anywhere long in college. He was like there for like 2 years in and out. So I don't know why he even got the job to begin with, but he's not good. Again, the Steelers run like 10 plays, and that's it. And he doesn't do anything, I don't think, to stress the defense, or he doesn't scheme up many things. So it puts the quarterback in a bad spot. Like, we don't use the middle of the field at all. Everything that you see is to the boundaries. It's a curl. We don't set up wide receivers to get a lot of yak.
Why is the run game so bad?
It's a multitude of reasons. All because, I mean, you can crowd the box. Everything we do is going to be short passing schemes. You can sit on everything. You can play one high all game. So that's part of the reason why everybody knows that if the Steelers are going to be successful and move the ball a bunch, Najee's probably going to have to have a good day.
Well, he seems like he breaks a tackle every carry, but he still only gets 2 yards. And it just blew my mind when anytime I watch them play the last 2 or 3 weeks, it feels like it just seems like every time they call a run play, it's like 2 yards, 3 yards at the most. And I'm like, I can see that he's not running bad. Like, he's slamming people off of him and stuff, but I don't know how you can break so many tackles and just not gain anything.
That's kind of what it is. I mean, the offensive line isn't great, but they've actually been improved this year for the Steelers. It's just it's everything, really. I mean, again, but it starts with the offensive coordinator, in my opinion. He's trash. And speaking of Pickett specifically, again, he just got to show that he can close some games. He's thrown the Jets game, he threw a pick. That kind of lost us the game. It was a tip ball, but still, he threw the pick. And he didn't finish the Bucs game. Of course, he got knocked out of that game. And this game, he didn't close. He had opportunity to do it. He was in some tough situations for sure. But you gotta show that you can close a game. And maybe we'll see that in the future. Maybe we won't. But you got to keep playing them, of course, and see what you got. I think overall, I liked what I've seen, besides the interceptions, of course.
Interesting. Yeah, I didn't expect that you were going to be like, yo, he's not any good or anything like that. Just like the excitement a couple weeks ago when he finally got him in there as a starter, and now you're a couple weeks later. But that's a good
I still think he's going to be a good player. It's just if he can take it to the next level. Interceptions are like some of the greatest quarterbacks had terrible seasons throwing interceptions their first year.
Yeah.
And I'm not comparing them to Peyton Manning.
He's going to be a rookie. I mean, you got to go through it.
Right, yeah. Right. It's just there's certain things. But, again, there's offensive coordinators and helping them out. You look at guys across the field like Mike McDaniels, who's literally just scheming open, wide open things across the middle of the field and stuff. Like,
boy, he's a genius.
We just don't our coordinator doesn't have those capabilities to do that.
Did y'all have any thoughts on Tua seeing him back?
He looked good his first 15 plays. the you know, their scripted plays or whatever that they run, he looked good. Yeah. But the Steelers dropped a legitimate 4 interceptions last night. They said it was the most interceptions dropped in the game all season.
No, I saw it. I don't remember how many I counted, but there was
I mean, multiple red basket. That were
easy ones. Right. Yeah,
the one Cam Sutton dropped, it was literally like in his face. Like, I mean, a child. Carter can catch that one.
Yeah,
I'm pretty confident. It's one of those. Hey, it was a lollipop right to him. So,
right.
Legitimately dropped 4 interceptions. So, I mean, overall, I think he looked good early on, but he should have been picked at least 2 to 3 times that game.
Yeah, he's gonna have a little rust. I mean, looking at it, of course, he just ignites the Dolphins as a whole just being on the field. They just play. You could just tell they just play better with him on the field. Yeah, obviously,
because he's
a starter or whatever. But he'll just get back in rhythm. I think he'll be all right. I mean, I hope he plays like ass for the rest of the season. But he looked decent. He looks good for their team. Did what they had to do.
Yeah, I didn't have any.
There's a few plays that he was like, where he scrambled or something, and he was still like low on his shoulders and shit. And
this is what about. I was interested in.
I was like, he gonna have to deal with this the rest of the season. Like every time he does anything, people are gonna look at him like that now.
Yeah, and I just at the I same hate time, it's like
they was talking about him, like, you probably want to take it easy. Like, you don't want him to play timid,
right?
You don't want him to start playing timid, because then he's gonna start fucking up even more.
Like,
you
gotta let him play how he play, but
he should be safer. He should try to inherit a slide in his game a little bit.
That's all I was gonna say.
Inherit a slide.
There was at least 2 rollouts where he was decided to take off, and rather than. Yeah, I don't even think he got the one specifically that I remember. I don't even think he got the first down. He's 3 or 4 yards short of the first down, and rather than sliding and just avoiding the hit, he kind of dives forward and still is way short of the first down. And I'm just like, yo, that's the kind of play, like,
the one I was thinking.
The announcers are going to be extra, and you know they're going to have their little talking point. Oh man, he should change. But just in all seriousness, like, if you just had these 2 concussions, like, that's an easy play where you could just slide and avoid a hit.
Yeah.
And it's not like you're being soft. It's not like you're playing timid. It's just there's a smarter play. It's the same shit that you say about Josh Allen. It's just like, if I'm not Josh Allen's size and I'm coming off of these concussions, it would be a really good time to implement a slide in that type of scenario. Yeah, I mean,
but he was trying to get the first down. Like, at a certain point, you just playing football. Red zone
that he was rolling out, and the defender is right there. He's like, you could just throw the ball. Y'all got another down. Y'all in the red zone. It was like 10 yards out or some shit like that. But he went in, tucked his head, and took a hit. It was like, that was unnecessary. It was an unnecessary hit to say. You could have just threw the ball away and played the next play, bro.
I don't even want to criticize his decision. He played football however he wants to play football. I don't care. It was, as a spectator, when I was watching those 2 plays specifically, I was like, I was nervous for him. I was like, oh man, please get up. Please get up and be okay. And that'll be something that they continue to say over the next few
weeks.
That'd
be crazy if it happens for a third time.
Yeah, then he did like legitimately
we
do
might
you
have
keep
to not
playing.
Play you for the rest of the season.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be on some shit like that. But I hate the. I don't think he should even be on the field right now. Shut the fuck up! Like, come on.
He was talking about his
like,
parents. How does his parents feel about him playing? He's a grown ass man. He can make his own decisions.
He
want to
play fucking football. Like, stop it, man. He should be on the field. He's been cleared by doctors for real this time. He took a fucking week off.
Yeah, I think this is a lot.
Play the game.
I think it's some double talk. I know what you're saying. I feel the same way you do. I think you're double talking from what you said.
But no, it's
right after it had just happened.
Right, because that's right after it just happened. So that's completely different. Now, this is, 3 weeks later from the initial concussion.
It is.
So, I mean, that's completely different thought. I mean, once you're healed from an injury, I mean, nobody knows if you're healed from a fucking concussion.
Yeah, that's my point.
Concussion.
We don't know shit.
We've
arbitrarily decided that we feel okay with a 2-week break, whereas 3 days was not enough. That may be true, and that may be like an accurate stance we're taking, but we don't know shit. It's just easy to say right after something bad happens, they should have known better. And then when something doesn't bad happen, and he dives for the first down, doesn't get it, nobody gets hurt. It's, he's got to be a football player, and that's just part of what
still
it is.
Play.
It's just double. It's just double talk. That's all.
I see it as in different scenarios. So, I don't know.
Oh well, we did the concussion conversation.
Yeah,
in length
for
last
sure.
time.
For sure.
What other games?
Man, I saw the ending of the Jaguars and Giants game. That was kind of wild. Jags, they were up pretty much the whole game, I thought.
Yeah, I believe they were.
And then Giants just came back. I thought this was a game that the Jaguars could win. And man, I might owe you some money on that shit because I'm looking at the rest of their schedule and I'm like,
I did this too.
I don't know if they can win.
There's five definite losses
easily.
So they've got six games left that they could win, and you just figure they're the Jags. Like,
I don't know
if they go 3-3 in this, you're not getting to 7.
This easy.
I mean they gotta win. Well, yeah, legitimate 5 more games, right? So
yeah, but like the other games, like the teams that I didn't count as definite losses. I get the half for
a tie, right?
No, fuck no.
Bro, that's fair.
It's not fair.
Is that a push?
No. The half. It can't push. Can't push on a 6.5.
Oh, shit.
That's why we put the line at 6.5. You dumbass. So
I don't
you going to lose this bet. You going to lose the Ravens bet, too.
For
I don't
tie.
Have to give you a shot. I gave you 10-1 on the Ravens.
Bro, that's half a game. That's literally half a game.
You're going to lose both of these bets.
That's all looking bad right now, too.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers can't finish the game.
Send me the
life.
50 right now.
It wouldn't be 50, though.
225s?
No, it's 20 on the Jags. It's a double on the Jags. I mean, I'll just say it, bro. I'm just saying, it's on the pod.
Was it recorded? Do we got,
it's on the pod. We got to look at the tape. It's on the pod, so...
Whatever,
it's
bro.
I don't forget these.
You
things.
Got kids. You keep the extra $5.
You got kids.
I ain't worried.
I'm just saying,
you
bro.
You got mouths to feed.
Either way,
keep
the $5. I'm just saying. I'm just being real.
Keep the $5.
I'm just saying. No, but they. So the Jags had a chance to win the game at the end, like a legitimate chance. Trevor Lawrence threw the ball last play to Christian Kirk. And he was literally like on the 1 yard line trying to push the ball in, and linemen trying to come behind him.
It
and
was
push
the Titans Rams Super Bowl.
Very similar.
The Kevin Dyson reach.
Game of inches.
Yeah, that was a wild finish.
Last play of the game type shit. Very, very
dramatic.
Depressing.
Yeah. ETN is the truth too.
I told you I thought he was gonna have a good year, man.
I knew he was good, but it's still just like in my head. I just couldn't get past the fact that they had such a good season out of James Robinson.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why draft somebody after? I still had that question, but I heard he had no touches this past week. James Robinson.
He did.
No, he ain't got no stats.
I'm looking at the wrong game. That's
no
why.
Touches.
Wow, I wonder why they did
That's
that.
That's crazy.
He had one target for a pass. That's all.
Yeah, so he was playing. Like, it wasn't
catches or nothing.
That's crazy to me. It's a waste. If you have somebody that was as good at running back as he was, why wouldn't you mix in both of them?
Especially
I don't understand.
Now, we were talking about earlier, you got everybody wants to have a 1-2 punch in the backfield.
Yeah.
You got the perfect one right there. Why not do that?
100%.
Yeah, I mean, maybe they just wanted to really get it, or maybe ETN was just going. I mean, yeah, he was averaging 8 yards a carry, so shit, I don't know.
Yeah, well, I could see that, too. It's... The Jags aren't good enough to have somebody with James Robinson level of production and not use him.
Oh,
is my point.
I would say that. Yeah, I mean, sure. And you can find a way to get them both on the field. ETN has like that. He could be like a wide receiver almost.
They were talking about using him at receiver when they drafted him.
Maybe an Urban Meyer wild
decision.
Yeah,
but
that makes sense. Christian Kirk is your best receiver.
Yeah, right?
Christian Kirk's not a bad player.
He is
but
good.
Yeah, he's not
like,
bad. No, he shouldn't be
get
your number one.
Yeah,
not he should not be your number one option.
Yeah.
And they made a mistake there. But, yeah, I mean, I think ETN's good, man. He breaks a lot of tackles for a little dude, too. He kind of reminds me of I don't know. I guess he could be like a Jamal Charles-like player. Not saying he's going to be as good, but like kind of that just that speed, but gotcha. Still has like that great contact balance, like Alvin Kamara-ish type player. So,
yeah, I could see that.
Yeah, for sure. He should be good. But, yeah, I mean, that was a devastating ending to the game if you're a Jaguars fan on that
Giants
note.
6-1.
All six of you out there.
The Giants.
Shit is nuts, so.
Nuts. Most surprising team. Dayball got it. To me, that's the coach of the year.
Yeah, I think he probably will.
He's doing more with less than anybody else. And that's why, like, the word really pisses me off.
They legit don't have a number one receiver.
Yeah, I mean, that's
legit. Christian Kirk.
They still got Slayton over there as their guy. Slayton's not that great.
Right.
And, I mean, that's what really pisses me off about.
But when you got Saquon and Daniel Jones giving you 220 yards on the ground.
What did Daniel Jones
run for? He ran for a lot like that?
He had 11 carries for 107 yards and a touchdown.
I didn't know that. Well, that's different.
Second one had 24 carries for 110. That's crazy. That's nuts. You're controlling this game.
Yeah, yeah. That's different. But, I mean, what I was saying is that's what really pisses me off when I watch the Steelers is just because I know when I'm looking at a team like the Jets or when I'm looking at a team like the fucking Giants, it's just no way that they have more talent. Right. You know? Right. Like, yo, it just really boils down to coaching. The coaching sucks. So, yeah, I mean, Dable's doing a great job.
He really is. Right, he really is. Good for him.
Yeah.
What were you telling us about the Ravens game?
Y'all didn't see the end of that shit?
I don't think I did.
I did see that.
I said the same thing about the Jags. So, when you described it,
The Ravens was fumbling the bag.
Well, yeah. The Browns drive down the field last possession. Mm-hmm. They just need a field goal. Is it a field goal to tie the game?
Yeah, it was to tie
the game. Mm-hmm. They get into field goal range just barely. Yeah. And
but didn't get the first down.
They send a field goal unit out there, and I don't know what happens, but like half of the fucking Ravens line jumps off sides.
Right.
That's what it looks like anyway.
I did see this. Yeah. I did see this.
And they showed it back. It looked like nobody on the Browns moved.
And right. when they showed it back, they called it on the Browns as a false start. And they moved them back 5 yards. The kick ended up getting blocked anyway, so I'm not sure if But they did say the kicker was up like half a yard than what he would normally be trying to make the field goal, or maybe like a yard and a half. Trying to make the field goal shorter. So maybe that did factor into the block a little bit. I mean, that could have been, that's significant, I would assume.
Yeah.
But, yeah, and, you know, it's been a lot of Browns fans pitching a fit about that, like, phantom false start call. And they said it was a few calls down the stretch
that
they were robbed by. But I think they did false start, but I don't think they were showing the right view.
It probably was somebody's hand on the ground.
I think it was the snapper, man. I think one of the angles that they showed, and they only showed it one time, and I'm not sure why they never went to the angle again, like from behind the offense. I thought I saw, they showed it really quick, the snapper like kind of lift the ball when he put his head down.
Right. That's probably
but
what
then
it was.
They called it on the wrong person then.
Yeah, they called it on the they didn't call they it on the snapper.
Didn't even move.
And they didn't move at all. But you know, referees do stupid shit like that sometimes. And maybe it was one of the cop out penalties, I don't know. But I felt like that's what I saw. And I didn't even know Browns hate type shit. Like that's literally what I thought. But I haven't seen that angle again, and I don't know why they wouldn't show that again. Oh, but maybe they were caught up in the number.
Trucks, man. Let's move on.
Yeah, I think they were caught up in the number that they called it on, and were just specifically looking for that person to move. But yeah, I mean that pretty much helped the Ravens out a bunch.
Damn, Lamar threw for 120 yards.
Yeah, I mean he hasn't had a good few games here, so it's not been a great stretch for him.
You say 250 is there?
How many did he have?
120.
Pretty good for a receiver.
Yeah, not bad for a running back, but I mean they gotta be better. They gotta be better for sure.
I didn't watch any of that game. I just saw that they had fumbled.
What game was you watching? You watching the Packers and shit?
I was watching the Panthers game and the red zone for the most part. I heard a stat on the Bengals, which I didn't watch any of their game, but they just beat the brakes off the Falcons, and just every time they had the ball, they were picking up 40 yards, it felt like, at least on one of the plays in that drive.
It was going off.
But this stat was crazy. I heard that they've given up 27 total points in the second half this season.
Who, the Bengals?
The Bengals. And no touchdowns. 9 field goals is all they've given up the entire second half for 6 games in or 7 games in now.
Yeah,
that's wild.
Yeah.
Just like the opposite of the Ravens.
Yeah.
Yeah, overall, it was a fun Sunday, as always, with the NFL. The games were not like the greatest of matchups. In all honesty, we didn't even really talk about the Chiefs and 49ers, but it wasn't that much of a good game. And it kind of lost something knowing that they just got McCaffrey. Like, we're not really seeing the 49ers. I'll be interested to see if those teams meet again. They're both very good.
I don't have no faith in them with the 49ers. Garoppolo, man. I don't care. He he's just not good in crucial moments, they got, man.
Statistically, the number one defense?
I think it's, if not number one, it's right up there.
During the game? We've seen many teams before get there, at least. We have one of the best defenses in the league.
Well, and I keep saying it, but it's the NFC, man.
That too.
Somebody's gonna have to win the NFC, and the Eagles obviously look really good. But there's just not that many teams that I would be like they're gonna be the ones that would be ahead of the 49ers. But whatever, we'll be back for another another football week for next week.
Yeah,
we've got our song reaction coming this time, so if you want to check out the song, today's reaction, we're going with No Cap. Song is called Heaven for Thugs, Letter to WAP. Don't know who WAP is, but we're going to find out. So if you want to listen, pause this too.
Whoever WAP is got him on that walk. He was off that promethazine on this joint, but he was leaning hard.
I think this might be my favorite reaction that we've ever done.
We needed this. We needed this.
That song was terrible. That was one of the worst songs I've ever heard.
I would agree. I don't think it's not one of the worst songs, but
one of the worst ever.
It's
one of the worst Young Thug impressions I've ever heard in my life.
It's not good. But I don't know. I haven't listened. I haven't been feeling No Cap here lately. The last few singles he's been dropping, he's getting away from what he does best. He do this shit okay or whatever, like when he does it like in spots that like singing type stuff. But what he does best is his wordplay. Like, get into your rapping bag. Like, that's what people like. No, that's what I like No Cap for.
He just heard that Wayne How to Love and thought he could just, you know, replicate that a little bit.
That was not good. At no point did he, I don't know, he didn't do anything like impressive.
All acoustic, by the way. Just straight acoustic. No beat drop, nothing.
Yeah, like you said, he was on something when he made that shit.
Had to be.
He was on something. He was definitely feeling a little too much of something at that time.
For six and a half minutes
of him just kind of crowing.
Like, yeah, just straight crowing.
Yeah,
you've got to tell us. You got to do some research to find out who WAP is. You got to fill us in because that didn't seem like it was like.
I think that's what he names what he has in his cup. He was that WAP in his cup. That's what it was.
It did not sound like a heartfelt letter. I don't know. I wasn't getting that vibe.
I don't know. That sounded like it was pretty heartfelt, but he just won't say shit.
Nothing.
He won't say anything. And that's, like I said, that's completely opposite of the No Cap that I've come to like. Like, he, again, is, if you really listen to him, you'll he get in his bag. Like, dude got some deep metaphors. But, again, I haven't. It seems like he's been trying to get away from that. I think he's been going over too many people's heads, so he's trying to dumb shit down, but that's not it. That ain't how you do it.
That was way too
right
dumb.
That ain't how you do it right there. I would agree. I didn't expect that.
That was great, though. It was great.
I didn't expect that.
That's the best part of all of us agreeing not to listen to these songs before, is we really have no clue.
What to expect.
No clue. It could be a great song, which we've had a couple of really good choices, or it could be that, and...
Yeah, that was fun. That was not it.
That was fun.
That's all right. I enjoyed it.
That's the first one that we turned off, right? So
yeah,
we'll keep a tally of those.
We skipped ahead a lot.
Y'all listen to it. Y'all turn it off early too. Y'all not listening to that full 6.5 minutes.
Yeah,
I promise you.
To do some shit like that, you got to be able to like sing. Or
I would like to hear actual Young Thug do that. He would have bodied that joint right there.
I don't know if I want to hear that. He's not saying nothing. I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear a bunch of... I would have liked it. I thought he was going to do his little Heaven for Thugs hook and then come in with them bars.
Right, like, and actually rap a little bit.
You know
bit.
What I'm saying? He didn't rap at all. And if he did, it was to a point that was too far gone in the song. Like, we're not listening to this point till you get your bars off.
He didn't want us to hear that if he did rap.
He did not want anybody. And it's like, I don't get why you dropped that as a single.
Yeah, that's a send weird, that to super wild. Weird
that's
choice.
A single.
Send that. I don't know.
It's out there as a single.
At least something we just threw out there.
Probably. Yeah. But send that to WAP personally.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't put that shit on platforms.
Email attachment.
Yeah, right. I may just jump for you real quick, bro. Yeah. Keep your head
Maybe
up.
Maybe he just hit submit on the wrong thing. He meant to submit it to email instead of submit it to the streaming service.
It was a mistake.
That's all that was.
Yeah, that wasn't it. I'm sorry. I suggested that one. But it was really the only thing I saw. So I'm like, oh, hey, I'll fuck with No Cap. And I know you guys don't listen to me. Dan has the wrong one to put y'all on the No Cap right there.
I'm already on.
He did like your boy No Cap no favors with that one.
Yeah. I like you fuck with a little bit No
I do,
Cap.
I do. I like what I've heard for the most part. Yeah, I don't mind him. And what's the other one? Who's the other one? It was a Lil. Who's a Lil you put us on? Papa.
Lil Papa.
Yeah, those are the two that you've shared that I actually like.
See, I should have picked the Lil Papa song, but I already heard that.
That's all right. We appreciate you being honest. Hey, they can't all be winners. It's fun to have a loser every now and then.
They can't all be winners, hey.
But this week, we did get new music from Mr. Jeezy himself, the Snowman.
Big Snow is back.
Snowman is back.
With drama. You already know what time it is when those two names are together. We back to Trap or Dying out here. That's what it's looking like. What's it called? Snowfall.
Snowfall.
Fire album.
Great
name.
Great name. Perfect.
Hey, yeah. It sounded, from what I heard, sound like Jeezy to me.
Yeah. None of that has changed.
Yeah, it sounds like Jeezy.
That Jeezy sound is that Jeezy sound.
Jeezy in his back. Well, I mean, the last few joints, albums wasn't really hitting like that. This one sounds like, all right. I think he actually put his foot forward on some, like, all right, I'm going to give y'all what y'all really want type shit.
I thought the last one was kind of good.
We were talking about it last week, and I don't remember what the last one was. But, the autobiography and Church in These
last
Streets.
Last one was the Recession 2.
That was the one.
And we already know what the Recession was.
I don't remember the Recession 2 at all, so it couldn't
You don't like the
home.
Recession, bro?
Two. No, I said we know what the Recession 1 was.
So to have
a Recession 2,
I was about to say, that's
you're putting a lot
of
expectations on that. And it wasn't that. That's all I'm saying.
Well, yeah, I mean, but come on.
Do you listen to the Recession 2?
He got like Duval in the feature.
Did I listen to it? I believe I did listen to it, but I don't listen to it today.
My point is I don't even remember hearing it. I might have, I might not.
I
couldn't
remember
even tell
any songs.
So
I can tell you that.
Church in These Streets
that's fair.
The autobiography are the last two that I actually remember like songs from them that I enjoyed. So it at least kind of flew under the radar. I did like this. I thought it was pretty good. I listened on the way over here. I was listening and then we were listening for a while setting up and stuff. There's a few songs on there that like I was listening in the headphones on the way over. And there was a few songs that like there's something about the beat that I didn't like. I don't remember which songs. I wish I had written down the names, but there was a couple. I thought it was just kind of busy. Like, it was just extra shit going on. And Jeezy's rap voice is so powerful. It's like, just let this shit shine. And I felt like some of the beat kind of took away on a few songs. But then once I got over here and we were just listening kind of in the background, it just sounds like Jeezy, man. I was enjoying it. Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
Off the top, the first song, Snowfall, then Kool & Dre produced that joint. We already know how Jeezy come with the intros.
I got beef.
I feel like he got back in that bag again. What you mean?
I heard you say that before we were recording. I just saved this until we were actually recording. What? But I know that he's known for that, for the intros.
Yeah.
I did not like this one.
You did?
And I really felt like it threw me off, like, my whole mindset listening to the album the first time when I was riding over here. Because that first
you
intro
the whole
fucked
thing,
me up.
Even when the beat dropped, you didn't like it.
So that was my complaint.
What?
Is I understand the idea of building the suspense and then coming in hard with that beat drop. Yeah. That beat built for like a minute and a half.
About a minute and a half.
It didn't come in until it was almost an hour 40, a minute 45 into like it. And I'm like, this shit is just too boring.
Yeah, and one thing I did notice, Drama was doing the running backs like on the mixtapes on his album too.
Fuck that.
Now, I appreciate that because I liked it when back in the day, but I think
I'm trying to get through this fucking song.
We've evolved from that at this point for you to do that on this album.
Yeah,
like I get it. Drama gonna talk your shit. Drama
one time
is
okay.
Mr. Thanksgiving.
Maybe.
For nostalgia. I think one of them I actually kind of liked. I forgot which one it was. I think it was like number two, bro.
Yeah, I didn't like that one either.
Bro, one of them
but what song do you ever listen to and it's like, if you're not in like a party or something, I don't want to hear it run back. I want to hear the fucking song all the way through.
And if I do want to run it back, I'll run it back.
I'll run the shit the fuck
I'll run it back,
DJ.
A verse and be like, oh God, Wayne killed that shit. I want to rap it all
again. I mean, but sometimes it works. Like Wayne on Cannon, when they ran that shit back, it was like, all right, yeah, you got to run that back.
Right.
Because he was going crazy. It was like,
is that something you want to hear every single time, though? Or sometimes you just want to hear him go crazy.
Right.
But when you've heard it like that so much, I can't hear that Wayne's without it being run back. I have to hear it with drama bringing that shit back and
but that's,
hit the body fall.
That's a little bit of like a nostalgia at this point for us because we loved it. I'm so glad you said that because I honestly didn't even catch it on. I don't think I caught it a few times where I didn't even realize it was a run back.
Yeah, if you're not paying attention, there was, you wouldn't. Yeah, they
there's
back
times
a
I'm
times.
Listening and I'm like, all right, I can kind of feel it building towards the chorus or whatever. Yeah. And then all of a sudden it went to a different direction. And I was like, I don't even know what's going on in this.
That might be why the intro is so long for that buildup because they do it in that. They do it in the intro.
Yeah.
So that might be why it's like double time for it to beat the drop.
Probably
they ran that
so.
Shit back a couple times.
But the intro fucked me up. It threw me off. And on the first listen, I was like, I'm not really sure I like this. Yeah. And once I got past that, I enjoyed a lot of it. That Dirk track is
favorite record
flames.
For me. Favorite record for me. That most hated is hard as fuck.
Oh my God.
That shit hard as fuck.
What Dirk say?
Dirk was spazzing.
He dropping bars on that junk, Eddie Andrew.
I had to call Carl back into the room and say, yo, listen to this right quick.
What?
Dropping bars on that.
I forget what he said. He said
he
something
said,
about
y'all
listening
listen
to
preachers. Y'all listen to something else. I listen to Yak or something.
Oh, I did.
Dropping bars.
As soon as he said it, I said, Carl, you got to hear this right quick.
Yeah,
but that song was
my favorite
song.
He was talking that shit on there, though.
Yeah, they sound good together. I didn't expect him to do a collab with Dirk. I didn't see this project coming at all. Like, I didn't know it was announced or whatever.
Oh, for real?
I didn't either till last week.
He been
when,
doing, he been
when
doing
Mosa
like a little
told
rollout
me.
For the last couple weeks.
No, I didn't.
Doing
I had
interviews
no clue.
With everybody and all that shit. So I knew that shit was coming. Actually, what was it? It was, I found out, I think he first announced it at that BET Awards when he performed with ESTG. That's when he announced that the album was coming. I think that was like 2 weeks ago, maybe.
Oh, okay. That's
ago.
Dope.
That makes sense.
Like that. But I fuck with it. It's good to hear Jeezy doing his thing again. I was watching a couple of interviews with him, and he was talking about he was actually talking about why his last few projects he was trying to work out getting out of his deal or fixing his deal up with Def Jam because he still put this shit out with Def Jam. But I guess he did it to a way where he owned his masters and all that shit there and all that. So he said while he was trying to get out that deal, those last two projects he got was like little throwaway joints. It was like
right.
throwaway projects.
Right,
and
right.
maybe that's why they won't really like that. And this one sounds like, oh, you back on your Jeezy shit again.
Could
which
be.
Is like, it's one of those things that's like, damn, like it sucks to. Cause I feel like we seen Wayne go through that a couple years ago. And it makes you feel like the artists fell off because they hadn't put out good shit, but not knowing that they working out shit in the background. So they just putting out little throwaway shit just to keep people all right. And then once they get out of their deal, they back on their shit and get like, they never really lost it. They were just going through shit with the business. And that's what it usually always comes down to. I don't think these guys really be losing it. They still got it. Just be some other bullshit behind it. They'd be like, all right, he had fell off now.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be like that. But of course, you wouldn't know. We knew about Wayne shit, but we didn't really know what the fuck Jeezy was going through. We just thought like, damn, Jeezy just ain't got that shit no more.
Yeah, he's not somebody that talks very often.
Right, exactly.
We don't hear from Jeezy.
He's talking a lot this week,
unless
though.
There's a reason.
Talking a lot. He was actually, that we was talking about earlier, I don't know if we recorded this, about Jeezy's ad-libs and how he kind of like brought that presence when he came in again. Everybody wanted to fuck with them ad-libs. He said the reason why he started doing ad-libs is, well, he originally started rapping. He wasn't even a rapper.
Right.
He was like Eazy-E. He just got a bunch of guys to rap and he would get the studio and pay for everything type
gotcha.
Of shit. He's like, then, you know, everybody started getting locked up and getting into their shit. He's like, I got all the studio equipment. I got to rap now. I got to use this shit now. I didn't pay for all this shit. Ain't nobody to rap. So he
that's
just started rapping. And he ain't know how to write bars and shit, of course. So he said when he would rap, it would be spaces in between his shit. So he was like, all right, I'm going to just start answering whatever I just said. And that would be like the ad. He didn't know it was an ad-lib or nothing. He would just be answering whatever line he just said. He would be like, yeah. He just
that's
be replying
hilarious.
To it. So
that's
I was like,
hilarious.
That's funny as shit to know now. That it wasn't on purpose. It was literally, he was like, I got to fill in this space right here with something.
Early Jeezy, he doesn't have a flow at all. It's just
no,
really
he just
almost
talking.
Like a lot of that shit is talk.
Yeah. Yeah,
it is like that for real.
I almost don't know if I wanted to know this.
I'm gonna laugh. A rapper. Yeah. Like, and like that's not how he started anyway. You know?
Yeah. But the ad lib part, like, yeah. I'm gonna hear like a super hard bar, and he does the ad lib, and I'm gonna like laugh.
Yeah.
Like, oh, he's being funny, answering himself.
It wasn't intentional at all. He was just trying to fill in the space between his rhymes because he didn't know what else to do.
That's crazy. That's hilarious.
Yeah, it was so much emphasis. He was just trying to fill a space. Yeah.
That's it. That's why it's so slow.
Yeah.
It's this weird delivery.
I feel that dead air in the song. I was like, oh, that's crazy.
That's genius at the same time, that's too, crazy. For somebody who doesn't, like, is not, like, a musical kind of person necessarily.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a good filler, and it worked out for him, apparently. Yeah. It's one of the more iconic things about, you know, his career.
Thanks. Right.
So.
Thanks. Yeah, one of the greatest of all time.
Yeah.
When it comes to ad-libs, for sure.
That was a dope story.
Like I said, I don't think he's recording his ad-libs anymore. They're plugging those shits in. That is a sound.
The Jeezy soundboard.
Yeah, yeah. That shit is a sound they're putting in. No way he's doing those shits anymore, but that's just dope for sure.
Yep.
Shout out to Jeezy.
I didn't see anything else that dropped. I didn't look. So you tell me, was there anything that we missed?
New shit from the OGs. Oh, that boy Friday that sang on the God Did Hook.
Yeah.
He put out a little EP. Shit is fire.
Yeah.
Shit is fire.
He's also, that's the dude that's also on Baby's album, right? Little Baby album?
He got a feature on Baby's album.
He spells it the same?
He spelled it with an extra Y. Friday with an extra Y.
All right. I'm going to look it up. I'm going to have to check that out. I like that.
Yeah, it's pretty solid. Roddy put out a new single, Aston Martin Truck, shit hard.
I haven't heard
back
that.
In his bag again.
I didn't either.
Yeah, I fuck with that shit. I've been playing that shit the last couple of days. But that came out. Then that was it. Had some R&B shit. You know, y'all be fucking with the R&B like that.
Give me a name.
Babyface put out an album.
Oh, yeah.
Good. I saw he put out a video.
Did it with all females, and he basically wrote and produced the whole album with the top R&B females that's out there.
Oh, it's people that we know. They're established artists.
That's probably pretty dope.
That shit's kind of fire. It looked like a little modern sounding, but songs is fire on there. That came out. Sonder came out, which is Brent Faiyaz.
Yeah.
And his producer or whatever. They put out a project.
That's I've only heard one song of theirs ever.
Yeah.
And I fucking love it. Yeah. So I'm going to have to check that out. I like him a little bit.
Yeah, you know, I'm fucking with Brent Faiyaz.
Girls Night Out. Is this
they put out a project, joint, huh? And I think that might be a
project. Goodness gracious. Ari Lennox.
Oh, we got to talk about Drama, though. Drama kind of like super in his bag. First of all, he dropped three projects on Friday. Because we know the Jeezy one. He dropped a joint with NBA Youngboy against the Grills.
Yeah, I did see that.
And a Snoop Dogg against the Grills.
I didn't hear same about day. That.
Drama going nuts right now.
Apparently so. His somebody else just recently did, right?
Off the hook, huh?
Didn't somebody else just recently?
I don't know. I don't know if he dropped
somebody recently. I might be thinking something else.
They've been talking about him doing one with I Swear Vezo and ESTG. Yeah. They've been talking about doing one with both of them, but he ain't dropped.
He really getting back to the streets, ain't it?
Yeah, and I heard he was on Joe caught him on his podcast, and he said he's about to drop his album called I'm Really Like That. I was like, well, Drama really out here flexing his muscle. He ain't won that Grammy with Tyler, and now he ain't lost his mind.
I was going to say,
Tyler. Got two of the hottest artists in the game with Uzi and Jack Harlow, and now you about to take over with the Gangsta Grills again.
Yeah, I think Tyler is the one that I was thinking of.
Yeah, that was the one.
That's
the
I didn't one. Know Jack Harlow was signed by him.
Yeah, Generation Now.
Signed to who?
Drama. Him and Lil Uzi.
Me neither.
I had no clue.
Got two of the hottest rappers Uzi. In the game signed to his joint. Crazy.
I think Uzi is cool. I don't think he's a hot rapper.
Oh, you must not know about Uzi. Uzi is like how Cardi is. He got fans like that.
I mean, I think he got a solid fan base, but I don't think when's the last time Uzi dropped like a big song?
He doesn't drop a lot, but every time he does, like when they said that the last album he dropped, he hadn't dropped nothing in like 2-3 years. Came back and did like 150. Something like it won't nothing.
I don't know. I haven't looked at his numbers and stuff like that. And I think he got hits.
Yeah, I think
overall.
He puts up massive numbers.
Yeah, he does crazy numbers.
I think this might be a blind spot. For
no,
you.
We talked about it on his pod last album he dropped. He hadn't dropped in like 3 years, and that the anticipation was so crazy that he should be like 150, almost 200 first week.
I mean, maybe so, but I remember listening to that album. It wasn't great. And I don't feel like a lot of those songs carried over. I don't know. I just feel like he didn't have like any chart topping singles or nothing like that. That's what I'm saying. He ain't been that guy in a while. But he's
just like YoungBoy. You don't have to try topping songs. No, you don't. No. Every time he come out, they show up.
But YoungBoy is different though, because it's like YoungBoy dropped 90 projects a year and shit. Like, if you look at the most recent joints that he's dropped, his shit ain't been doing crazy numbers like that. Because he just, it's that.
He's dropping so much. He going crazy this year.
He dropping an album like every week and shit. He just dropped an album titled the week before last, titled like "Ma, I Got a Family Now." Like, nigga, yeah, you on your 10th child.
He is kind of on his 10th child. That shit crazy.
You wildin'.
Yeah, but it's kind of, it's the obvious for Uzi, because now he goes so long and builds up that anticipation for his shit so much.
That's a possibility.
That every time he show up, they showing up for him.
I think Uzi's just
his
not
last
on,
project.
He's not on any of our.
Oh, it's an EP, though.
Yeah, I don't think he's on any of our radar, like, properly.
Right.
I don't, bro, is he not?
I mean,
he's not
know,
really
I know
popping
him for what
like
he
used
I know
to be.
What he is. Like, he
did. They said his last EP did 20,000 units.
Look
but
up,
that's an EP, though.
Look up Eternal A Take.
Yeah, that was the last
A-T-A-K-E.
Album.
A-T-A-K-E.
Yeah, Eternal A Take was the
this
last
is 2020.
Album.
2020. That's not that long ago.
Eternal A Take?
A-T-A-K-E.
Yeah. That's the one I think I'm talking
and
about.
And that one's got hits on it. That one is actually the one that I'm most familiar with. I like five songs.
It ain't got hits on it, but it got some
you
decent
think Uzi
record.
Don't got hits?
What was the number?
Like, initially, when he first came numbers? Out, he did have hits. Dang, it did do 288.
Yeah. So this is what I'm talking about. This
different,
is
bro.
This is your blind spot, the way the NBA
yeah,
used to be
March,
for us and Kodak
March is 2020.
Yeah. He liked that, bro. Like,
yeah.
you're not knowing.
Yeah.
Every time Uzi pop up with something, they coming.
Million U.S. streams or some shit like that the first week.
Who were the couple of albums you said that are coming up next week? Or coming up soon? You had announced a couple of them.
Drake, 21 Savage, dropped the video for their Jimmy Cook's record on Drake's last album. And they announced that they have an album dropped this week. Is her now? Is her what? Some shit like that? I forgot the name.
No idea. I told y'all I just heard that song, right?
What?
That Jimmy Cooks.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't I tell you that last week?
Like a couple, yeah.
Fucking fire. That shit is so hard.
Bro, it's so many songs on that last Drake album. That was so hard, bro. I can't get off the Lil Baby album, bro. I listen to that shit. I listen to it every day. I'm telling you, that shit is so fucking good. I listen to that shit. Especially the first half of the album is. I don't know. It's really that's my shit. Like for real. But he'll be quickly replaced this week. The GOAT drops on Friday. So, you know that Cutthroat.
Oh yeah, Roddy.
DMX.
Oh, no, he ain't dropping Friday. He dropped a couple in November.
No, that Cutthroat Bill drop this Friday. Kodak the Boss.
Which week? He passed away.
Yeah. All that shit. All that.
That's well, good. That'll so give us
I'm excited
something
about that.
For next week.
Oh,
why
yeah,
you trying?
And
why
and
you trying to throw shit?
Next week. Yes.
Oh, why
I can't even talk about it.
I know. I'm gonna send in my notes, and y'all gotta go over my shit.
We will. Send it to us.
Yeah, I'm gonna send over my shit.
Yeah, email it to me.
Yeah. Okay, I got you.
So we'll cover it. We'll start the pod with your stuff.
All right. Cool. I appreciate y'all, boys.
Yeah. But yeah, Roddy announced Feed the Streets 3. November 18th is coming.
Okay. That's good to know. November 18th.
There's something else coming out
in
November as well. Maybe like the week before the 11th. That maybe seem. I don't know. I can't remember. I thought it was a major artist that was going
to
drop.
In that time, you know, them ones going to start dropping. We already know what time it is.
Yep.
So.
Well, we got like 5 to 10 minutes-ish here.
Damn shit.
Got about 10 minutes probably. You want to tell us about this? Rory Maul, Joe Budden situation?
Oh, yeah, okay.
What's this update? I haven't heard anything at all.
Right. Of course, you know, I listen to both odds every week. They both drop twice a week. So I think last week, Rory Maul dropped a pod with Saha.
Yeah,
back when they was all on Joe's pod, Joe and Saha had like a little back and forth. They had a little, you know what I'm saying?
I could never tell if that was legitimate or not.
I think it was legit.
Angry or if it was like a friendly thing.
I don't know if it's like no like beef, but I think, you know, Saha, they just, every time something comes up, Saha always bring Joe up, it seems like, every time I've seen him in interviews.
Yeah.
Because they had a little back and forth. Si was calling Joe out to, you know, rap for money type shit when Joe ain't rapped in like 6-7 years. It's not going to happen, but it is what it is. They went on Roy's podcast, and I think he brought up Joe again and said some other shit. So I called him out. And then some type of joke was made about, the money. You could putting up money to rappers, so you ain't got to put up the money. And Maul made a comment, oh, yeah, it's all right. It'd be my money or some shit like that. You know, how he do. You know, he just stole that or some shit like that. I mean, some type of reference like that he stole the money from. So, all right, that happened. I think Joe's next pod to drop, apparently a little clip of Joe, like, directly getting that Maul, wilding on him or whatever, was in it. They took it down, took it off, like, 2 hours after they had dropped it. Don't know why he did that. Should have just left it up, I guess. But they ended up taking it off. But, of course, once it's on the internet, people had the clip.
Yeah.
So they was playing it. He was getting his shit off.
I'm going to find that clip.
I think I got the clip.
Oh, you the man.
Nah, I'm thinking about it. Of course, you know, Act posted the clip of Joe going in on Maul because, you know, him and...
Shocker.
He's still beefing with Rory and them, but it's what Joe did. What is that about? They played a song.
I'll say that's interesting. That's a diss track. I didn't know that was coming.
Maul, not only did I not steal from you, you have never had anything worth me stealing from you.
I know that.
No matter how many new beginnings you start, and no matter how many of these new people you get around, some of us know you. That would be me. So please stop spreading these lies. You've never had anything for me to steal from. That's not the nature of this relationship. This is some sick role reversal shit going on. And I'm not mad at nobody else calling me a thief. But you can't call me no fucking thief. No, I will not have it. You've never pulled your own weight. The first never meant nothing to you. It's never been like responsibilities. You never got up and carried your own shit. It's always been another nigga around to help you do it. And you don't speak to them niggas no more neither. So this is not Joe specific.
Sheesh.
Stop putting smut on my name. I'm going to start showing up for myself because that's my problem with the fucking internet. Y'all don't know nothing about none of these niggas. All of them. The whole industry. And niggas get a mic with no fucking resume and just get to talking and Maul.
He went on. So that created a response from Maul and them. And then they put a little clip out with going in, calling him a thief, saying he used all his money to pay for bitches and clothes and all this shit. It's kind of, you know, is what it is. Joe and them responded, and they kind of like had like, they didn't say it in their names specifically, but they basically kind of like had a conversation about it on the next pod. And which was why I fuck with the new guys, because they do kind of like check Joe whenever he getting his little shit. So yeah. Him and Ish, one of the new guys on the show, kind of had a little good back and forth on some shit. Like, he straight up asked him, like, why don't you show the account? Because Maul called him out just to show the account. Just, if you ain't still done, just show the account. So he asked him straight up, why you don't show the account? And Joe's response was, because my feelings were hurt. He said, because my feelings were hurt. If you dig deep into it, I can see why you would say that. But to that be your response as to why you won't show the accountant is hilarious.
It is funny. It is funny.
It's hilarious.
But I'll be honest with you. This is why I used to fuck with Joe.
Yeah.
Because Joe is a weird dude.
Yeah.
And like that type of like, I'm sure he made a joke of it and stuff while they were doing
it. They were joking, but they were kind of going back and forth. And
but really it's like, you could tell, I didn't hear it, but I believe that's probably a legitimate response from him.
Right.
And it's like something that most people just get mad and they like don't really dig into their feelings at all.
Right.
So they're just like, nah, fuck that dude, because it's fuck that dude.
Which is why like, I think
Joe kind of digs into his emotions and stuff different than most men do, to be honest with you. I operate similar to how he does.
Right.
But he's just like, because they hurt my feelings. Like, it's just mad honest. It's funny, but
which
it
is a simple
it is
answer.
Honest.
It's funny, but it could be possibly true.
Yeah.
Which is like, I was why I understand why they had eyes, of course, over whatever happened, this, that, and the third. But it's like, they both just have different perspectives on what it is. y'all feel like y'all came to him feeling like he wasn't giving y'all the full of what y'all was supposed to be getting. He feels like I'm the reason y'all are here in this position because I brought y'all along.
Getting anything.
So for y'all to ask me, like, I'm stealing from y'all when I brought y'all in on this, it can feel disrespected. It's like, if I brought y'all in on this, and then y'all come to me like, I'm stealing from y'all when I put y'all in a position, it's like, what do you mean? I feel disrespected. Y'all not my friends if y'all think I would do y'all like that. So it's one of them things like, why should I have to show it? And then he went and talked about it. He was like, even if I do show it, that's not changing nothing. We still not going to rock. Ain't like we're gonna piece it up afterwards. No, it still is what it is. So why we keep doing this? And they just went back and forth about it. I'm trying to understand it. They got to just let it go. Just let it go.
Yeah, which is, I mean, both sides are clearly, like, they were so tight.
Yeah.
It's clear that both sides, but like, really have hurt feelings involved. And you can tell because they both bring it up still. And yeah, Rory and Maul do it the most. But yeah,
that's what it is. Rory and Maul still take shots very frequently about Joe on the pod. Like, it's almost like at least every other pod they're making a reference about. It. Which right. is cool. They're going to joke. But it's part of their thing or whatever. Joe don't really address them at all. Until now. This is like the first time he's addressed them since the shit happened.
Well...
So it's like he don't never really address that. I think they might have had a little back and forth about it here and there. He don't ever put their name in the pod. If he does say their name, blink it out, but you know who he be talking about type of shit. But he don't take no shots. He let it be what it be, and it is what it is. He just move on whenever that's brought up to the situation. Roy and Maul, they feel away.
Yeah.
They still feel away. Like
they 100% do. I'm just saying, like, it's understandable for the party that, like, still has everything intact as far as, like, from the podcast and the business perspective is concerned. It's understandable by why he would be easier able to just move on.
Right.
Whereas they feel like they were fucked out of something. And it's like, nah, I'm never going to forget that. Fuck that dude. I'm going to bring it up next week,
but
too.
But still, like, they established now, too. They got their, like, podcast rolling for about a year and a half now. They, you know what I'm saying? They doing their thing. They on tour right now.
But if you feel fucked over by somebody.
Right.
You're just going to hold on to it.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's stupid.
I can see both sides. It's just one of them things. It's just, I mean, it just depends on what position you was in. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
that's true.
If you Joe, I mean, he not wrong for the way he feel, too. Like, yeah, I mean, you did put these people on. Like, they do owe you for that. And they might not be wrong for feeling like they wanted or deserve more out of the situation as well, too. So, I mean, like, I can see both sides in it, but... It's hard. I think that clip was hilarious because that's kind of like the response I would come back with. Like, he really just shit on Maul for a second there. Just belittling type thing. But
Maul did it to him. I mean, he marked it off.
Yeah.
Called him a thief and said everything that he pays for is my money. He's like, it's my buddy. It pains him. He said it pains him every time he gets to the barrier and looks at his Balenciaga. He knows I paid for it. Maul was going in. So it deserved a response, I would think. But
I think I did see that clip.
Yeah, Maul was going in.
I didn't even pay attention to like what he was talking about. I did see that clip. It pains him. I remember hearing him say that.
It pains him.
Over and over.
Every time he goes to the strip club and throws him tips, it's with my money, with my face on that money or something like that. He was just going in. It's like, all right, well, you got to carry it a little bit, but I feel you.
All right, well, I got a question now because Carl was trying to show me something on the phone. I assume, since you were showing it to me, that it was important and it had to do with the Panthers.
No.
All right, good. Well, what was the breaking news?
No, it's just we're talking about James Robinson earlier, and he didn't get any touches and shit. They're trading him.
To?
Jets.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good move for all Brees parties.
Hall. Yeah, that's they just lost a running back.
What'd they get for it?
It's a 6th-round pick that could be a 5th, so they pretty much got what they invested in him.
Oh, it's a good move for all parties.
Yeah, for sure.
Good for James, good for the Jets, good for the Jags, the 3 J's.
God damn it. I thought we were going to have to deal with no fast-ass running back. They got James Robinson.
Well,
it is what it is.
We really only got a couple minutes here if we got samples. So any other final thoughts, words of wisdom, or anything that you gentlemen wanted to bestow upon us?
Final thoughts. You probably shouldn't talk crazy about people that you're in business with.
It's a good idea.
Because they probably just start to just remove all the business they have with you.
It's probably a good idea.
Shout out to Ye.
Yeah.
the boy not crazy. Well, we can move on. We can move on.
Any words of wisdom?
Dumbass.
No. Ugly.
I don't have any either. I'm actually gonna try to start putting together a word of wisdom.
Yeah, I've been slacking.
I really think like either just hearing something or just I should have something to provide here, but I don't. So next week we'll see what we got. But we got these samples coming. We appreciate everybody for watching. If you're on the YouTube, we'll be back next week. If you're on the audio, we got these samples coming for you.
Yes, indeed. Peace.